Guys, Ashish this side. So this is part 3 of Netherlands series, and in this part I'm going to tell you about the admission process, eligibility criteria, steps to apply and intake timeline, and the documents required for admission. So a lot of content that I'll cover in this video. First we'll see is eligibility criteria. So admission percentage, you must have 65% or above in the previous education. High ranked universities may ask for 70% or above. That means in your 12th or in your bachelor's, depending on the courses you are applying. Mathematics is mandatory required for applying to a bachelor's program, other for courses relating to the arts stream. So if you are mainly STEM is quite popular in these universities, in the top universities of Netherlands. So for those courses, they may ask mathematics as a mandatory subject. And also GMAT is required for MBA in high ranked university. But again, I'll tell you that these are the standards requirement, and university to university's requirements may vary. So it is always great to find out which is the university you are applying and then check their particular eligibility. But anyways, now coming to IELTS. So bachelor 6.6 bands with no band less than 5.5, and for masters you need 6.5 with no bands less than 6. Some programs may also need IELTS score above than 6.5 or 7 bands. So that totally depends on university to university, but this is the standard requirement of eligibility. Next you have is how to apply. So there are two ways to apply at Dutch universities. Universities accept through their website using their own online application modules. So then you may find university like Hans US, like Leiden University, like Groningen. These are some universities which accept directly, while you may also find universities accept application through a study link. So this is again a common portal, common application portal kind of system for Netherlands. An online enrollment system, universities like In Holland University, The Hague University, NHTV, Breda University are some example which accept through study link. So the more you research, the more you will find out that which kind of system they'll be accepting. And any which ways, I'll tell you how you can inquire to us also if you're interested in studying in Netherlands. So we can also help you in that. Now, you will have to make an account on either the college website or study link to provide your basic information, submit the scanned version of your documents, and pay the application fee. You will be informed about the application process and its stages through this account. So next comes is the application fee. So all colleges require that you pay an application fee while applying. The fee amount will differ depending on the college and course being applied to. So you can check with the individual institute, university for the application fee. Next comes is what are the step-by-step procedure to apply. So one is you search for colleges and courses. Second, you contact school or visit website for information. You narrow down your list of schools. This is the most important thing. Do not get confused in many university, and if you are still in the confusion phase, then stop. First find out and confirm these are the list, these are the university that you are applying to, then only move to next step. So next step is take the language exams like TOEFL or IELTS, or you have STETS exam in NT2. So this is maybe particularly exam for Netherlands, and then you write your motivation letter and ask for letter of recommendation. So these are the documentation that you require. Motivation letter is just like your statement of purpose. Next you have is apply to the colleges which fits your interest. Then you appear for video interviews of the colleges that shortlist you, and then if you are shortlisted, you will get the offer letter, and then if accepted, you apply for student visa. So student visa part is something we are going to cover in the last video of this series. Next comes is motivation letter. So a motivation letter is your introduction to the college admission and admission officers. It is always written in first person and describes the reason for applying to a particular college. It needs to highlight why you are a perfect fit for the college and why the college should accept you. All in all, who you are as a person, what are your achievements, what you have done so far, and with that, how good you can be for the university is what it is all about. Next is essays. So essays are also required to be submitted by prospective students. Essays are an important part of the university admission process. Students may be required to write one or two essays along with a few optional essays also. Some of the common topics may involve strength and weaknesses, skills, experiences, reason for considering a particular school, etc. Then you have his letter of recommendation. A letter of recommendation is a reference letter written by a third party describing qualities, characteristics, and capabilities of the prospective student. So a third person will be writing about you. So that is the ability to perform a particular task. The third party could be your professor, if you are working, then your direct manager, company, or something else. Now, next is the intake timeline. So you have winter, which is September, October, summer intake, which is February. General deadline for applications are for winter, it is 1st April, 1st May, and for summer, it is October. So if you are going in February, then October is the deadline. And if you are going in September, October, then April, May is the deadline. Now, next is what are the documents required for admission, or what are the documents that you need to prepare to be ready for admission. So all your mark sheets, 10th, 12th, if you are going for masters, then bachelor's, result of TOEFL and IELTS should be ready, result of Dutch language test, which is NT2, only for enrollment for programs in Dutch. So in case you are going to apply for Dutch program, in case you know the Dutch language and want to study in Dutch program, then this is the language test that you need to pass. If you have work experience, then two letters of recommendation from the employer manager and your motivation letter, which I told you what it is, and it is similar to your SOP. Next is resume, then portfolio. In case you are applying for art or design courses or architecture courses, then you need your portfolio. Apart from that, you need certificates, achievements at the state, national level, and extracurricular activities, your proof of funds, health insurance, and a copy of your passport. So these are the documents that you must have. Those should be ready before you start applying, start your application procedure. So with this, we have come to the end of part 3. In part 4, I'm going to tell you about the top scholarships, about 10 to 15 scholarships in Netherlands, the cost of study and cost of living in Netherlands. So that would be important for you to understand and plan your budget. In case you have any query, then I have put in the details in description on how you can contact us for your queries. Please like this video, comment, share with your friends. If you have not subscribed yet, then please do subscribe. This channel has a lot of content when it comes to study abroad, be it different countries, courses, universities. You can find a lot, so do explore that as well. I'll see you soon in the part 4 of Netherlands series. Till then, stay connected.